Today we're going to work on a couple of the problems from 10.4. We're going to work on numbers 1 and 4. The other ones are done in another video. So what you want to look at when you're talking about radicals and combining like terms, you're combining like radical terms, right? So you want radicals that have the same index and the same radicand. So this works just like variables. Radicals work very similar to an X or a Y. They need to have the same, it says they need to have the same index and the same radicand. So what that means is if I had something like 2 radical 2 plus 3 radical 2, I have the same, they're both square root. We don't have anything written there, so they're both square root. And then what's under the radical is also the same. So as of right now, these two do not match. However, we need to be looking at, can we simplify them and then possibly do they match? So we're looking at, can we pull out any perfect squares? So we're gonna start with 3 and then 24 can be, we wanna break it down into factors, kind of like we were doing in 10.3. We're gonna do 4 times 6 because 4 is a perfect square. So then whatever you bring out, you're multiplying. There's multiplication here in between. So I have 3 times 2 radical 6, okay? Plus, because I still have my 54 here, okay, so radical, and what can 54 break up into? And the ones I see is 9 times 6, because 9 is also a perfect square. So plus 3, the square root of 9, radical 6, okay? If you remember, the square root rule said that if this is true, then also square root of 9 times square root of 6 is true. And the square root of 9 goes to 3 times the square root of 6, okay? So, now I have 6, 3 times 2, radical 6, plus 3, radical 6. So now you see they're both the square root, and it's 6 underneath of both of them, so I can add them, just like if this was 6x plus 3x. So we're talking about the same thing here. These two radicals represent the same thing. So I get 9 radical 6. Okay. Likewise, when I have x's and y's, it works very much the same. I just still need to practice with my numbers. So I have a 5 out front. I don't want to lose that. Radical, what can 12 break down into? And we can write this as 4 times 3 times y squared times y, because if you remember your exponent rules, when I'm multiplying, I add. The reason I do this is because this y squared is a perfect square, and now it will come out front, which is what I'm looking for. So my 4 breaks down, and my y squared breaks down. I get 5 times 4 goes to 2, and y squared goes to y. Leave everything else, the 3 and the y, under the radical. If I keep going, I get 10y radical 3y. And now I'm looking at the second part, right? So it's still plus in between. That's what it was up here. That doesn't change. 6 radical, and I have 75. So again, I want to think about factors of 75. And the ones I see is 25 times 3. My y cubed can again break up into y squared times y. Okay, so now break down what you can. The 25 can break down and the y squared. So plus 6 times 5 times y radical 3y. Get plus 30y radical 3y. So if you look at these two, right, this one is 10y outside and the 3y inside. This one is 30y, so it has a y, and the radical 3 inside. So these are like terms. I can add these two just like they're like terms. So looking at that, I have 10 plus 30 gives me 40y, because it's just that I have 40y's, radical 3y. So it looks a little uglier, but it's very similar to just working with variables, with letters, when you're working with the radicals. But you have to be comfortable with breaking them down, with knowing what numbers are factors of each other, and then what they simplify to. So remembering those perfect squares will be very helpful. And then also paying attention to your letters and what can come out and what cannot come out. If this one had a Y and this side did not, you would not be able to add them. In order to add them, they would both have to have a Y out front.